Wednesday afternoon we're live in Liverpool at Radio City, and the boys from Busted are here, and they've got the real Liverpool experience today. They've got the, both the highs and the lows of the Radio City Tower. It's swaying, boys, isn't it?
Yeah, it's like being at sea.
It's like the seasickness they've sampled, so they were up here for a bit, and then they had to go down to the crowd outside. How did that go?
There was a lot of people.
Yeah,
a lot more than we expected.
Yeah, I don't know what we expected, but there was loads of people there.
Yeah, mate, we didn't give them that much notice, so people would bank off work, off school.
Yeah.
So how does that feel? Does that still feel nice when you get all these people outside and you still want to...
It feels amazing.
Pictures,
you know, it's kind of, I don't think you ever get used to that. I mean, it's always kind of a bit like, wow, why have you come to see us losers?
Well, that's nice, isn't it? That's nice and modest and down to earth.
Yeah.
I like it. That's why he gives his number out too often.
Yes.
Right, so the pigs can fly, so let's kill the obvious one first. Why pigs can fly? Who's going to fill me in on that?
Because it was the idea was coming back was just so far-fetched. We believed there was more chance of pigs flying than the band coming back. So when we did come back and announce the tour, we decided to call it Pigs Can Fly. Because it was like, you know...
So it's 12 years.
If this can happen, anything can happen.
Yeah, exactly.
It's 12 years since you first did your last tour. Right.
Yeah, we did our last 2004, the end of 2004.
Yeah.
And the opening one starts at Wembley, where you did your last one?
Yes.
How does that feel? Does that just happen, does it? Or
no,
that's what you wanted?
That was on purpose.
Was it?
We wanted the first show
to be with the last.
Yeah.
Then we kind of go around the country and end up back in London for the O2, so it's wicked.
What would you say? So I know we're all, you're a little bit older, you don't say that, but what's changed since that tour? Your rate of recovery any worse? Like when you go on the lash nowadays, if you go out and it takes you a few days to go.
I've noticed that recently. My hangover's getting much worse.
So is it the same when you're on tour?
I think what's great is we've had a lot of experience in the last 10 years. And we were quite naive from the first time around, we were very young. And it feels good now that we're sort of, we come at it from a new perspective. Yeah.
Right. So what can we expect from the tour? Is there anything different?
What
are you excited about that you're going to showcase at this tour?
I think what we're really excited about, I mean, apart from just touring in general, which is, you know, especially being back at 3, which is amazing, but we've kind of we spent quite a long time kind of formulating what we were going to do live, because we kind of wanted it to be something different. I mean, not only we hadn't done, but no one had done. And so we kind of came up with this this idea for a fully interactive, immersive gig experience where fans can actually come on stage with us and be part of the show.
Wow.
So they will actually be on stage with us for the entire gig and be an integral part to our show.
Yeah, that sounds amazing.
It's
unique.
It's safe.
Yeah, it's never been done.
It's such a great idea as well, isn't it?
Special ticket, and it's not just for one song, like this ticket will get you on stage for the entire show.
So what is that? Is that a same ticket that will get you to the
Yeah, park? There'll be details on
we
the
could, yeah, we
website.
We
obviously
could,
everyone can't get on stage.
Yeah, but we could.
Yeah. We're 200 tickets per night.
We could,
and first come, first serve.
Wow, that's how good an idea is that?
We had to wait till now to do it, because it took a while to make the stage a certain way. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So
logistically, a headache. But
yeah,
I think it's going to be awesome. It's like no one's ever done it before, so you're kind of treading new ground, and it's a bit of an unknown. We're not going to have to rehearse it, so it's kind of nerve wracking. So we're going to be nervous anyway, and then that adds another tier of nerve.
It's like an extra step to the goal zone, isn't it? There's front now, and then there's on stage.
Exactly.
Yeah, there's extra on stage.
They're going to go quick then.
So happy. So plus they've got stuff to do. Like they're a part of the show.
It's an interactive gig experience.
They have to interact with us and do certain things to make the show work. So it's going to be wicked.
So it starts at Wembley on the
11th.
Yeah. You get to Liverpool on the 22nd.
Yeah.
22nd in Liverpool. Always like a good Liverpool show. They're a rowdy crowd up here.
Do you understand some of the Scouse Liverpool words that we use?
Give
it's Bostad.
Ah, he's on the bus one. Jay's on the bus one.
It's Bostad, isn't
it? I'm not the boss.
Do you know what boss means?
Yeah.
Oh,
good.
Charlie's not on the boss one. Boss is when something's like, it can't be better.
Yeah.
It's like,
you're the best.
A whole superb.
Okay.
It's boss. But it's got to be said with passion. It could be
said.
The boss of everyone, of each year's it, but it's got to be like, oh, it's boss. That's how boss something is. It's just at the best. It's boss.
That is
boss. That boss. Boss. They've nailed the boss.
Boss.
Boss. There's another one as well, which is when something's not quite that good.
Is it just sound?
Sound.
The tournament of the boss.
Sound.
Above that sound. It's just what it looks like.
Right. Boss. We're heading for boss.
This is going to be a boss tour. So I asked a few people. I asked a few people on my Facebook to compile some questions for you.
Right.
So,
okay.
Don't know who wants to answer these. Right. Martin, who's from West Derby, if she's watching the video, hi to you, Martin. Wants to know if you're going on holiday, if you have a break, what tunes do you have on your iPod that you listen to by the pool?
Ooh, good one. Pool tunes.
Well, this time.
Are you using like a chill? Are you using
pool tunes? Is a different category of tune. It's like, you know, you have your songs on for your family, and when you get to the pool, I like stuff like Daft Punk and that kind of stuff. Because a pool vibe is a different vibe.
Pool vibe, yeah. There's a pool side.
Are you listening to music by yourself or with
the crowd? With the crowd.
No, but your headphones are on, aren't you? You're by the pool, you've got your small speedos on. And you're lapping up the sun, and usually your iPods are saving if you're trying to get a bit of a tan.
Well, so your headphones onto yourself?
Yeah, yeah.
Ooh, it could be anything.
Yeah, it could be
anything. Come on.
Could be anything. I went on holiday recently and I just listened to all new albums.
Cool, that's it.
On repeat.
Cool, that's it. Right, okay. Millie, who's in Kirby.
Hello, Millie from Kirby.
Who is the most vain out of the three?
Vain?
Don't say the fence, boys.
I don't think we're a very vain band.
We're not that vain. I mean,
I'm friendly. I wouldn't drop anyone in it, Millie.
I wouldn't call you Charlie or James vain. That means it's me. Oh, sorry. I wouldn't call any of us vain.
Okay. So there's no Spice Boys in here. They're all sound.
Right.
Well, I thought we were boss.
Yeah, the tour's boss.
We're just sound.
Sound.
Right. We're boss, but the tour.
Helen.
Boss, but this.
Helen is in West Kirby. And she's asked, who's the biggest moaner out of the three?
Oh, that'll be Simpson.
I reckon I'm a bit of moaning, but
the thing is, it's endearing, Charlie's moaning, because it's
but
really
when Charlie moans, it's hard to hear what he says, because all of a sudden, something will happen, he'll be in the back seat of the car going, Charlie, what are you moaning about?
A mumbler. Right, okay,
mumbles.
Right, Jess. Hello to Jess.
Hi, Jess.
Who is on the phone the most?
James.
Hey, James on the phone.
Really?
James Bourne is literally.
James is attached to his phone.
Is it you?
You're actually lucky he's not on it right now.
I'm on mine. Well, yeah, I'm only looking at the question.
My phone's not here. Where's my phone?
Do you never have them phone panic attacks? I had one. I read this thing where there's this new thing which is phone addiction, but you're actually addicted to getting updates on your phone, right? And the sign that you're addicted to your phone is, you ever have phantom buzzes?
Yeah.
So your phone won't be in your pocket, but you feel it buzz, and you go for your phone. That's a sign that you're addicted to your phone.
I do that all the time. Who's had the phantom buzz?
I've never had a phantom buzz.
No, but I have been very upset.
You've never
before.
Just felt your phone buzz, but actually it hasn't buzzed.
Right.
Yeah, but I have been very upset before if I hear a phone call and it's my friend's phone ringing, not mine.
I mean, that's
That's very upsetting.
You've got a cop on.
That's very upsetting. You think it's true, and it's blowout. It's like both people pick their phones out of the pocket, and the one who it isn't is the blowout. So.
Have you ever done that to embarrass? Like when someone lets on to you and it's not you and you go, it's not your phone, you got.
Yeah. Phone going off in the cinema, a bit of a shocker.
Right. Matt.
Yes.
Hello to you, Matt. Not you. Matt, that's the question.
Matt. Hi, Matt.
Who's the big party animal, Alias? Who will be the last to roll on?
That'll be Charlie.
It used to be Matt, and I just took the baton.
Charlie's now the biggest party animal.
So I handed the baton over in about 2006.
Yeah. You're that's 2009. Yeah.
So you're the last one on. If you're out on the
line. Yeah.
Chaswick's now.
I'm like a paint Liverpool red one up here.
Yeah, you should do, you know. You should do
it. Very good.
I'm not sure you get through some of the doors. Big strapper, didn't he?
Levels, it's always saying downstairs, you go to levels and like, level Wednesdays.
Level Wednesdays.
Yeah,
three floors,
a
bit of everything.
You go on levels,
Frank?
Same as Bosch.
Yeah. But just
as if we know
about it.
Who said that?
Someone outside.
Yeah.
Outside, yes, I have no idea what level it is.
So it's level Wednesdays.
It's like, it's level Wednesdays.
It's student night.
On a Wednesday.
So funny.
So I've got to do, I'm doing a big competition on Saturday afternoon on my show here on Radio City to give tickets away. Cool. VIP tickets. I don't know whether they're on the stage ones. I haven't read the email properly yet. But
they're not. We're being told, give them the nod that they're not.
They're not.
The LMFG ones.
They're the best.
They're very good seats.
LMFG, arguably.
OFG is probably one of the best. You've got the best view
in the house.
It's the best view for this show.
Yeah. Right. So we've got these tickets to give away, but I want you guys to think of a question for the listeners, and we'll use this on the radio Saturday.
Okay. Oh, we think of a good.
Yeah. Can you think of a
this,
good?
This building is swaying so much.
I know
that I'm literally feeling a little bit sick.
Like, I can feel it. I've been feeling it.
Right. Okay.
What's the question, James?
The question is.
Here is the question.
For the ticket.
It does not have to be related to us. Maybe anything.
I'll count
you can do whatever you want.
Five, and you have to come up with the question. You ready?
It does not
have
to be related to us.
One.
Not
two,
your one. Anything.
Three. Four. Five. Question.
What is Charlie's middle name?
Good one.
Google may help.
Right, there's the question, what is Charlie's middle name? If anyone knows it, these amazing tickets. Is he busted on the 22nd of May for Liverpool? So come and see them in Liverpool. The tour starts on the 11th.
Yep, 11th at Wembley.
Get your tickets, boys. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Hope you can go and have some seasickness tablets now and a good lie down for the lads.
Yeah, we're up to levels.
That's what he's thinking.